Hi, I'm Greg Bedell. I've learned from working in radio that all it takes is a couple of hiccups or bad decisions, and suddenly you can find yourself in an incredible credit jackpot. Do what I did. Call Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants at 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Put an end to the harassing calls. Don't let your credit score drop. That's what Bill did for me. It was a disaster, and over a period of time, he gradually got my credit restored, and today, I bought a car, I have credit cards, I own a house. He's the guy that made that possible. Again, Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants, 954-581-5050. 954-581-5050. Or go online to talkaboutcredit.com. Tell them you heard about it from Greg Bedell. And remember, if your credit score is dropping and you have harassing phone calls, this is the man that could put an end to it all. Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultant.
Sweatshop labor in a foreign factory, and gets packed on a vessel and shipped over the sea. It's loaded onto trailers and it's spread across the map.
Big Box Mart is the place I go to buy all of my crap.
Oh, Big Box Mart,
what do you have for me?
'Cause our shopping carts are empty and we're on a shopping spree.
I come to the Big Box Mart 'cause I do have lots of needs, and they sell crap the cheapest with their discounts guaranteed. When I'm walking through the aisles, it's like I'm hypnotized. With a wallet full of credit cards, I never leave deprived.
Oh, Big Box Mart,
thank you for serving me. 'Cause my house is full of crap now and it used to be empty.
The next day at the factory, the news was very grim.
My job was being outsourced to the slums of East Beijing.
Management was streamlining the company's org chart.
We gotta make crap cheap enough
to sell to Big Box Mart. Oh, Big Box Mart,
look what you've done to me.
He's gotta start all over at the age of 53.
I still go to Big Box Mart, yes, I'm there most all the time. These days you'll likely find me sweeping aisle number 9. My dreams of a retirement have gone up in a blaze, and I'll be scrubbing toilets till they stick me in the grave.
Oh, Big Box Mart,
what have you sold to me?
We used to be your customers, now we're your employees. Oh, Big Box Mart,
my paycheck reminds me your everyday low prices have a price.
They are rent free.
Paper or plastic?
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
This is the Credit Report with Bill Lewis, a daily forum for business and financial news, politics, economic trends, and cutting-edge issues. The Credit Report is brought to you by Credit Restoration Consultants, the leading credit restoration firm in South Florida. Schedule your free consultation today. For details, go to talkaboutcredit.com. Join the discussion live. Call toll-free 888-565-1470. That's 888-565-1470. Now, here's Bill Lewis.
And thank God it's Friday. Friday, August 7, 2009. Unless, of course, you're listening to the weekend show, which means you have more too much time on your hands than time will allow. I'm Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report here on 1470 WWNN, a daily forum for business, financial news, politics, economic trends, as well as cutting-edge issues. How many of you out there are paying attention to the Cash for Clunkers program? How many of you are familiar with the fact that just recently, I mean, over the last 24 or so hours, the United States Senate approved and sent to the White House a $2 billion extension of the Cash for Clunkers Automobile Sales Incentive Program? Well, you know what? The measure was approved on Wednesday, 60-37, sent to the White House. And, of course, signature happened, signature came, $2 billion was entered back into the program. That $1 billion program that they started last month, well, you know what? $1 billion was just gone in a matter of days. That's $1 billion, billion with a B. Yes, that's right. But you know what? $2 billion was pumped back into the program on a 60-37 vote in the Senate, extending the successful program that has raised United States auto sales up out of the water, up out of the slump over the last year or so. And the initial $1 billion of funding that was approved in June for the Clunker business has generated more than $920 million in rebates and more than $220,000 in sales over the last couple of weeks. And those of you out there that are wondering more about the program, you know, that incentive was going to assist overall U.S. auto sales that were down 12% in July over last year. You know what? Right now, the United States auto sales are reporting their best performance of the year. And for those of you out there that aren't familiar with the program, you know, the Cash for Clunkers, the CARS program, well, the program offers consumers a federally backed rebate of up to $4,500 if they trade in their own vehicles for a new, more fuel-efficient one. In a few moments, right after the break, Rick Case, mega car dealer Rick Case, is going to be on the line talking about the Cash for Clunkers program, the different incentives that are offered by not only the United States government, but his dealerships throughout South Florida and throughout the United States themselves. And we're going to talk a little bit more about what Rick Case and Rick Case Automotive Group can do for you in conjunction with these particular Cash for Cars type programs. But most of you out there are familiar with it, and you're really not sure how it works. You know, the who, what, when, where, and why. And, of course, you wondered about the $1 billion that was pumped into the program. You know, you hear about all these other Barack Obama and the presidential and the Senate and the House, of course, supporting these different initiatives. But it seems as though this is the one program, or at least in the consumer's eyes, that appears to be, at least on the face, at least on the cover, working. Now, who knows what it's going to cost later, but imagine this, 220,000 auto sales in the last couple of weeks. And, you know, there are a lot of people out there that says, you know what, Cash for Clunkers is the only program that has succeeded so far. And there are individuals out there, according to, matter of fact, Dave McCurdy, who's chief executive of the Alliance of Automobile Manufacturers, which incidentally is the trade group for General Motors, Chrysler, Ford Motor Credit, Toyota Motor Credit, as well as other big car makers, says, you know what, this is the one program that has succeeded. And, of course, the program, well, who is it helping? Well, those individuals with clunkers, obviously. We'll explain what the definition of clunker is later on. But you won't find those cars back on the road because one of the prerequisites of the program is to destroy the car. And I was wondering how they were going to do that. And we'll talk with Rick after the break about that. But, you know, there are methods in which the car dealers, after they receive their rebate, are able to destroy and seize up the engines. That way these cars do not end up back on the market. But whether it be a domestic or overseas manufacturer, so far they have pretty much split the clunker market. You know, more fuel-efficient passenger cars have outsold sports utility vehicles, pickup trucks, as well as vans. And, of course, the idea here is to become more fuel-efficient. And according to the administration, who was stunned by the swift success of the initiative, they were obviously stung by a series of administrative glitches that started the program off. Of course, they didn't expect 220,000 cars to be sold in a matter of days, but they're attempting to ramp up and attempting to improve the process in issuing rebates. They've warned that the clunker measure could be suspended again. Actually, it wasn't really suspended per se, but suspended again if the $2 billion you know, runs out quickly. And, of course, what, 220,000 cars is $1 billion, so you figure maybe another 440,000 cars and automobiles out there that could be sold over the next couple of weeks. But you know what? $3 billion so far pumped into the Cash for Clunkers program, and after only 1 week, $1 billion was gone. And you have to wonder, the automobile industry, the related businesses, the persuasiveness of dealers out there who employ thousands of individuals, okay, individuals that not only contribute generously to political campaigns but are involved within the communities. How is this program working? But according to the National Automobile Dealers Association, they say future demand is open for question. And open for question in what regard? You have to wonder. Showroom traffic kind of remained stagnant for a while, but all of a sudden it started picking up again in relation to Cash for Clunkers. All right, Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report, 888-565-1470. That's 888-565-1470. Your opinion does matter, and this is a daily forum for business, financial news, politics, economic trends, as well as cutting-edge issues. Have you been paying attention to the Cash for Clunker program? Well, the Cash for Clunker statistics so far reveal a very surprising trend that the automobile industry themselves did not expect. I mean, first and foremost, that program, the Cash for Clunker program that gives consumers up to $4,500 toward the purchase of a new, more fuel-efficient vehicle. Well, the program came out. The only difficulty they had, of course, at the very beginning is the rules, the rulemaking authority. And although the rules were announced kind of sort of the day after the program came out, there was a lot of information about how the impact of the program was going to become, how the Cash for Clunkers market was actually going to work. You got to remember, the majority of the eligible clunkers that are being traded in so far are domestic vehicles with over 100,000 miles. And the majority of new vehicles that qualify for the larger $4,500 rebate versus a $3,500 rebate are for lower priced cars, because smaller vehicles normally have a better mile per gallon rating average than the larger, more expensive cars or trucks. So you have to wonder, you know, the rare exceptions in the case are the hybrids that cost more. They qualify, obviously, for the $4,500 because of the fuel efficiency. And the best deals for the Cash for Clunker program are the less expensive vehicles that are costing between the $10,000 to $18,000 range. And, you know, in dealing with the sales, you know, the conquest sales, as Rick Case would sit there and say, and Rick, of course, Rick Case is the owner of one of the largest privately owned dealers in the country, Rick Case Automotive Group. They announced that they were going to help consumers, okay, when the loss of the customers would be eligible, and they have done so. They have pumped out hundreds of cars within the community. They're doing their part within the community. And, of course, the Cash for Clunker program, okay, is, so far, according to statistics, an overwhelming success. Now, you want to know about some of the other stats that are being reported? Well, first and foremost, most of the sales are basically conquest sales, and more than 70% of the clunkers were domestic. So more than 70% of the vehicles that were traded in were, for the most part, Fords or Chevy trade-ins. 71% of the clunkers were SUVs. Imagine that, 71% of clunkers that were traded in under the Cash for Cars program were sports utility vehicles. 93% had over 100,000 miles on them. And of course, 71% of those vehicles qualified for the maximum $4,500 trade-in, because SUVs only need a 5 mile per gallon improvement to get the $4,500 rebate versus the $3,500 rebate. And of course, the 71% of clunkers were in fact sports utility vehicles. So that's why the 71% obviously kind of sort of matches up. Oh, and of course, the average clunker trade-in gets 17 miles per gallon, where the average new vehicle that is being purchased under the CARS program, the Cash for Clunker, gets 25 miles per gallon. So, overall, take 25 and 17. The average improvement is 8 miles per gallon. All right, Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report, 888-565-1470. And yes, your opinion matters, but you have to pick up the phone and dial that toll-free number. Be right back.
This is Jennifer Lewis for Pat Residi and Tom James of South Florida. If you haven't seen my husband Bill lately, wow. The reason? He just got outfitted with a brand new wardrobe from Tom James Fine Clothing. The Tom James Company is the world's largest manufacturer and retailer of custom clothing. They plan, coordinate, and maintain your wardrobe so that you're perfectly attired for any occasion. Business, casual, social, or formal. So if you need the perfect attire and you need the perfect touch of class, call Pat Residi at Tom James of South Florida. He's even giving you his personal cell phone number, 561-789-4357. That's 561-789-4357. Or go online to tomjames.com and be sure to tell them that Jennifer Lewis sent you. Tom James, the best kept secret in elegance and refinement.
You own a business, but you spend too much time chasing your customers for payment. Your customers are slow to pay invoices. They avoid your calls. Uncollected judgments are piling up, and your current collection agency is no help. Tired of hearing the checks in the mail? Write down the phone number for McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates, 800-699-DEBT. That's 800-699-DEBT. McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates is a South Florida-based professional collections firm, and they can help you to collect the money that's owed to you. They work on a contingency basis, so if they don't collect, you pay absolutely nothing. Collections on bad checks, delinquent accounts, judgments, and all types of overdue receivables. They can even handle background checks, credit reporting to all three credit bureaus, and